Are you struggling to build amazing standard operating procedures for your company? Maybe you have your operating procedures already in place, but you don't have a good way to share them with new hires or help onboard new team members. Well, that is exactly what I am faced with in my own company right now, and so I am working on building my own standard operating procedure playbook. I'm doing it with two of my favorite tools, Airtable and Loom. And that's what I will be breaking down for you in this video. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back. If you're new to this channel, my name is Gareth. I am the owner here at Gap Consulting, where we make it our mission to help you save 20 hours or more of your time every week with no-code tools. Now, if that sounds too good to be true, it's probably because you have not learned about the power of automation, being able to do automated processes in the background of your work so that you're not stuck putting in the time and the effort of doing them, but those repetitive tasks are automatically being completed while you're focusing on bigger picture stuff. That's the secret of automation, and I invite you to join me in my free webinar where I'm gonna teach you the fundamentals of automation. Check it out at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration to learn about the building blocks of no-code automation. But without further ado, let's hop into the heart of this video where we're talking all about building out some SOPs, right? Standard operating procedures for your business. There are a lot of different ways that you can share SOPs, but especially in the digital era, it is so, so valuable if you can help walk people through a standard operating procedure with a screen share. And that is exactly where a software called Loom is coming into play. Now, if you haven't used Loom before, they have a freemium model. I have an affiliate link actually below in the description of this video. If you're interested in signing up for Loom, I would love it if you could show some love back to the channel and use that link. But either way, Loom allows you to start off for free with some limitations. I think that your video length is capped at around 5 minutes and you can only have so many videos. But with a modest $8 per month per user, you can then go into their paid plan, which allows you to have unlimited videos of unlimited length. Now, I don't use Loom for things like this YouTube recording because I have a lot more advanced editing things that I want to take care of before I publish a video to YouTube. Same thing with my courses. I don't use Loom anymore to record courses because there's some more fancy editing that's going to go into that. But for those quick screen captures where you just need to share some ideas really quickly with somebody on your team and even have an archived version of that, Loom is key. So for this, I use it constantly. And another possible use case for you is responding to emails with a quick personal message. It really helps drive the customer experience to the next level. And so I use Loom for all these things. But for the particular example of today, we're not only just talking about using Loom to record some videos. Sure, that's one part. But the other part is how do we structure it so that we can store that information and quickly and easily share it with our team members when the time is right. So for that, my friends, we are gonna pop into Airtable, and I'm gonna actually build this from the ground up with you right here. We're gonna add a brand new database to Airtable by clicking Add Base. Of course, the first thing I'm gonna wanna do is rename this to be SOPs, and we can pick a different color if we are so inclined. Let's go with this blue, and I'll close down my getting started because it's not my first rodeo. I've built a database or two before. Now, the good news here is that this structure is super simple. We're not gonna have a bunch of data sets here. We at most will have two, but you could even get away with just one. And that data set that you must have, of course, is the actual SOP itself. So I'm renaming my first table SOPs. Now, as far as the elements that we need here, let's go ahead and delete all of our pre-existing fields, except for our primary key, which we'll come back to. One thing that you might want would be order. If there is an order to the different tasks that you're putting together in an SOP documentation, well, then you're going to want an order field here. I'll use number, obviously, and just go to integers. And that way I can sort or put things in this particular order if there is an order to the different trainings that I'm posting. So I'll go ahead and sort by that particular field so that they're always going to keep this order. Now, the next piece is what team needs this information? So I'm gonna build actually a single select field here. Maybe we have a couple different teams within our organization and certain SOPs pertain to certain teams. We can put all of our SOPs in one nice place and use this single select field to delineate who can see them. For example, let's say we have a marketing team and a finance team and a sales team. I can go ahead and create this field. Maybe I assign them very vibrant colors, but I'm going to create this field when I'm all said and done, save it up, and now I can determine which team is going to be connected to each of these different pieces. Let's say all of these SOPs are for my marketing team. The nice part about this is I can create different views for my different teams. And I'll just do that here, create a marketing view. And this particular view is going to contain all of my marketing SOPs. Of course, in order to make sure that it's marketing, I will apply a filter here, add the condition that the team is marketing. And now I'm only going to see the marketing SOPs here. So if I go back to my original view, let's actually rename this all SOPs. And if I built some other SOPs here, let's say this is my fourth SOP and it belongs to my finance team. Well, my marketing team is only going to see those three marketing SOPs. So this is a great, quick, easy way for you to put together a bunch of SOPs and then share these views with the appropriate or respective teams. That way you don't have to worry about re-sharing this information when you get new people on the team. There's one link for the marketing team. So if you've not ever done that before, all you need to do is go up here to the toolbar, say share view, and create a shareable grid view link. And this right here, this URL, is going to be the SOPs for that particular marketing team. And you can do this for each one of your teams. Now, similarly, you might also choose to add collaborators. Maybe you don't want to share a particular SOP with the entire marketing team. No problem. What we'll do instead is create a linked relationship here to people. So, very simply, we create that second table. This is that optional second table I was talking about. And I'm going to get rid of all of these extra fields here. And just to keep it simple, I'll just use first names. Let's say it's me and one of my hourly consultants, Connor, and then one of our developers, David. So I'm going to go ahead and just put these folks in here. If I wanted to share something specifically with someone here, I would build a linked relationship to the SOP between the SOP and the people. So do that here. I'll build that link. And this is where we're using the relational database element of Airtable, linking to another record, specifically a person record, and one or more people could be linked to a particular SOP, so I will allow multiple linking here. Go ahead and create this field, and again, now I can say, well, this particular SOP pertains to Gareth and to Connor, where this particular SOP only pertains to David. Okay, just as we built that marketing view, now we can build specific user views as well. So I can say David's view, for example, and in David's view here, this time I will apply a different filter, not filtering by team, but instead filtering by people and saying that the person assigned to this SOP must be David. Pretty straightforward. I only see that one SOP for David. And if I'm back here in all SOPs and I just want to share a new SOP with David, that's easy. I just select him from the list. And now in David's view, obviously, that's going to be filtering in the new SOP. The best part about this is, again, all I have to do is create that one view for David, go ahead and create that shareable grid view link, and then David can bookmark this link, and anytime he goes here, he's going to see the most up-to-date version of the SOPs that have been shared with him. So far, so good, right? We're able to build out these SOPs, assign them to specific teams, assign them to specific users, but we haven't actually gotten to the part where we're building the SOP itself yet. So let's do that. We're going to add a URL field here, and this is going to be the Loom URL. And I'm going to just simply select URL type here and create this field. And I don't particularly think that bringing in just a straight URL looks all that good. I prefer to use a button. So I will say watch SOP. That is going to be the action that occurs when somebody clicks this button. And I'm choosing the field type of button. And the URL that I'm going to be opening up, and let me rename my label here, watch SOP again. And I can make the button, you know, change the formatting, make it a little sexier. The action is to open the URL. What URL? Well, I'm referencing the URL formula in this particular field, that URL loom field. Let's go ahead and bring that in and create the field. And of course, there's nothing here because there is no URL here. I cannot click this button because this URL does not exist. So let's take a look at what Loom enables for us. I'm going to pop into my Loom here. And when I want to create a new video, all I have to say is new video. Let's say, for example, that I was trying to teach someone on my team how I upload videos to YouTube. I might walk through those steps. First, I would go to studio.youtube.com, and inside of my YouTube, I would come up to the upper right corner, I would click on create, I would upload this video, go through my whole process. There are a lot of different steps to this, but how cool is it that I could capture this all on a Loom video? So going back here into my Loom, I can simply say, create a new video, record a video. Now, as soon as I make that selection, I've got a few different things I have to pop through. When I decide if I'm going to start recording, I can choose if I want to have a webcam on me or otherwise. Very often, I'll just X this out because I am most focused on capturing what's happening on my screen when I'm recording an SOP. And I simply say, start recording. Because I'm using my microphone right now to record this YouTube video, it doesn't understand what it's supposed to be listening to, but I would say, yes, proceed, and it's gonna ask me what I want to record. Is it your entire screen? Is it a specific window? What exactly are you recording? And then once you say, go, well then, the recording's gonna count you down, just as it is here, 3, 2, 1. Now all of a sudden it starts your recording. You can talk through whatever's happening on your screen. Show them in this example, well, this is how you upload that YouTube video. You come up here, you say create, you upload a video. Here are the different steps, the end. When I'm done, I come back down here and I say finish recording, or hotkey Alt Shift capital L. When I'm done with that, I get this video automatically uploaded to Loom. I can rename this particular thing. So let's say this was upload YouTube vid. And I can even add a tag here, which would allow us to sort the library inside of Loom. But because we are storing this information in Airtable, I can skip that step and simply capture this URL. Go into the share up here and simply say copy link. This is the URL link that anybody who has this link can now watch this particular Loom video. I go back into my Airtable SOP table and paste that URL here. And you see, as soon as I put that URL here, now I have an active button here that someone can click on. I also want to grab the name of this particular SOP. Record YouTube or upload YouTube video, something like that is what we were using for our example. So I have that now. And anybody who either has the marketing team view or is assigned here and has their own personal view set up will now be able to watch that Loom video through their own read-only Airtable view. So let's go ahead and test this out. We're going to actually assign David here because David already has his own special view. We know that as soon as we select David here in the list of people, that this video is going to show up in David's particular view. We need to now make sure that we're not hiding that SOP field because we built this field after we created David's view. So I can now make sure that I have the proper button here for David. He probably also doesn't need to see the people, so I can hide that field as well. So what David does care about, of course, is the order of these things, the name of the different SOPs, and he wants to be able to access that SOP and review it anytime he has questions so that he knows the right procedure to follow. So what happens? We share this view with David. He uses it every time he gets stuck. He clicks on this link, as he may have already had it bookmarked, and he simply says, watch this SOP. I need to remember the steps for how to upload that YouTube video. When he clicks on this, it's going to open up that Loom recording, and right here, he can just watch that video step by step, pause, rewind, whenever he needs to. It is the cleanest, fastest way to build SOPs that I have ever discovered. I hope you got a ton of value out of this video and that you start implementing SOPs like this. It's so easy to do, so easy to share them with people on your team and make sure that everybody knows what they're supposed to be doing and how. If you have any questions, please drop them below. Be sure to subscribe to the channel if you want to stay on top of these no-code tools, and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts, We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.